What's up, YouTube? So I'm here on macOS Sierra, and I've had a lot of you guys ask me to do a performance review for my MacBook here. Obviously, it's going to vary for each model that you have, but I do have a mid-2012 MacBook Pro. I have freshly updated it to macOS Sierra, and I have been using it for a good solid day now as a daily driver just to see how it handles. Now, I do want to throw it out there. I have found some bugs and glitches. I gotta say, I'm pretty impressed with the quality of this build, especially for a very first beta to the, developers. Is usually they're pretty hard on us and they give us a pretty bad build, but this is usable. Besides a few, show-stopping glitches that I would recommend that most users do not upgrade to macOS Sierra unless you are intentionally using it for development. But I did just have an issue with the App Store here as it was trying to open. It hung. Chrome only works with the beta, and if you even with running the beta, it still sometimes crashes. Certain things, like as you can see, iStat menu or whatever it's called, is working here. So a few applications do work. A lot of screen capturing software doesn't work, like ScreenFlow, and I've had some issues with Final Cut Pro as well. Besides that, that's kind of standard. None of these apps have been updated for it, so that's one of the big reasons I would say don't upgrade to it. I did enable Trim, so the Trim developer actually opened it up and updated it for macOS Sierra. I do have an unofficial drive in here, and I do have Trim enabled, so that is still possible to do. And then I also seen somebody was talking about security and privacy that you can't allow from anywhere on macOS Sierra, but I still have the option, so maybe that's just a glitch on their side. Anyways, I wanted to run a Geekbench to show you guys the performance from this build to the last builds. I do have an example from Geekbench here that I can show you guys. Just got to shut down all of the apps, and then so my MacBook Pro usually sits between this as a multi-score or as a multi-core score for 64-bit. So let's see what it does on macOS Sierra. Just make sure we run the right one. Alright, so here we go. My multi-core score looks pretty low. They actually both scores were pretty low. So that could just be because I do also have a screen capture running in the background. It is harder to say. I did run these scores before and I did hit a little bit of a higher single core score, more in line to this, and then definitely a higher multi-core score. But there you guys go. That's kind of the basic jump in for performance. Everything else seems to be pretty smooth. Using Siri sometimes it takes a little bit to respond. Just like, go, hey Siri, what took you so long? And then there the speech back was, there was no speech back. Anyways, so that's macOS Sierra. Like, it is in its first beta build, so it's actually really good for its first beta build, and I'm pretty impressed. So thumbs up to that. Definitely hold off though, maybe for the public betas until you upgrade one of your main machines. This MacBook, I can deal with the bugs because I have another system to use, but you wouldn't want to use this if it was your everyday computer. Thanks for watching. Make sure you like this video, subscribe to the channel for more, and we'll see you again next time. Cheers.